is a quick video running through creating a connection from the cloud router to Google. First thing I'm going to do is navigate from the Fabric portal to connections, and I want to create a connection. I'll go down to Google Cloud Platform, and I want to click Quick Connect. From here, I'll input the pairing keys that I generated from the Google Cloud. It's a quick verification that'll go through and verify these are for US East, which is where I wanted these connections to be made. I have a primary and a secondary connection. Next, I'm going to click that I want to initiate these from a cloud router. Ashburn, I've got one cloud router available here. I'll give these connections a name. Oops, this is the bandwidth field here. For my secondary connection now. Automatically inherits the same rate. From here, we'll just accept the terms. I'm not changing any information. If I wanted to change or add any email addresses to get alerts about these connections, I can do that now. I can add an optional purchase order number or reference ID. These are all optional fields. Let's go ahead and create that connection. You'll see now the connection's been submitted. And after a few minutes here, we'll see that these will initialize, layer 2 will be completed, and then we'll go into the next step of configuring layer 3 or configuring BGP. In the next step, we'll jump over to the Google Cloud. And from here, we want to make sure that our connections that we created have been enabled and we've configured the Peer ASN. We can do that by going to Edit and adding the Peer ASN or confirming that it's there and clicking Save. We want to do this for both connections. Once that's done, we're going to use the provided Google Cloud router, BGP IPs, and the BGP Peer IP, which in this case will be our Fabric Cloud router. And we'll navigate back over to the Equinix portal and configure BGP on the Equinix side. For the next step, we want to make sure that we navigate in the Equinix portal to our connections inventory. And from here, we're going to select each of our Google connections. We'll start with the primary first. We'll select routing details and configure routing. From here, we'll utilize the peer IP addresses that we got from the GCP side. We'll enable BGP. Let's double check that ASN here. 16550 for the Google side. And the peer side, which would be Google in this case. I didn't specify an authentication key and I didn't enable BFD. So from here, we can apply these changes. Let's go back to our connections. Let's do the same thing for the secondary connection. Routing details, configure routing. Same here, no authentication key and no BFD enabled. We'll apply the changes. And after a few minutes from our connections page, we should see these connections go green. In the next part, we want to verify that BGP is up. One thing we may want to check is on the GCP side, after we configured BGP on the Fabric Cloud router, we'll come back to the Google portal. Make sure that there's not an additional step where we need to accept or approve or otherwise enable these connections so that BGP can come up on the Google side. There are some settings and during the creation process of these connections where you can take additional steps that you then have to approve before BGP actually comes up and starts advertising routes. So it looks like everything's up here. We can actually see that BGP is up from the Google side. What we'll do now is back in the Equinix portal, jump over to our cloud router here. Make sure I'm in the right project. We'll look at our active routes, load active routes. You can also see our connections. We've got redundant connectivity with Azure. In this case, I've got a single connection redundant connectivity to GCP. And I do also have a connection to AWS all off of this cloud router. So we look at our routes here now. Okay, we see for our GCP primary and secondary connections, we're getting our subnets from GCP through 1080.0.0.24 and 1090.0.0.24. And we're getting these advertised from both the primary and the secondary connection. The last part here, what we'll do is take a look at the route tables on our AWS And Azure sides, let's make sure we're getting these routes from GCP. So I've got here my AWS route table. We can see that we've got routes for 80 and 90, usually going through the virtual gateway that I have this Direct Connect attached to. So these routes are being propagated from the Direct Connect gateway. And the target here is the virtual gateway. So it'll go back through towards the FCR. So if I had VMs, if I had resources and was looking to reach either the Azure or GCP network in this case, we do have routes now for those. And let's take a look at the Azure route table as well. So again, we have our 10, 80, and 90 routes. We can see the path here, 13.5.3.1 is going to our FCR. So that's the Equinix ASN for Ashburn. And then the next hop in the path there, 16.5.5.0, which is the ASN for Google Cloud. So it looks like in this case, we've got connectivity with GCP. We've got routes that are being propagated from GCP. They're then being propagated to our other peers, in this case, our Azure and AWS environments. So at this point, we have interconnectivity between these three cloud environments through the Fabric Cloud Router.